game. It was very close for a while. All of a sudden, things got way too out of control. We'll see them ban out the Shadow Fiend on side of Burton, and Abraxas banning out the Dazzle, so neither of them want to play with those heroes again.
Yeah, and last game, I actually want to put it on the Shadow Fiend factor a little bit. I mean, we saw Arlous just explode on net worth as Shadow Fiends do sometimes, and was able to do so much, just being able to provide the damage, and also just the scary potential, the scariness of a Shadow Fiend just running at you, just making you go get the hell out of there. Same for come with me here on the clockwork. Really good zoning play there, and even inside the enemy base. But yeah, this game not gonna see. I might see another clockwork here, but we won't see the Shadow Fiend, as you said. But instead, we're gonna see the Lashrak here manage to slip its way through the first banning phase, and Abraxas take that up immediately. It's gonna be up against a Tusk and a Storm Spirit though.
Yeah, and Storm Spirit has fallen off a lot recently, in my opinion. Glimmer Cape is just too good against him. I mean, you see Storm Spirit zipping at you, you just Glimmer Cape and walk away. You're good. And then he has to either commit more mana, or just say, okay, I can't kill you, and leave. And which generally takes, well, more mana.
Yeah. Well, but yeah, Storm Spirit still, I think it's a decent enough pickup up against Lushrak if you do get to that spot where you can snowball, right? If you get a decent enough start, if you don't really get shut down too hard in lane, if you do get up to a Bloodstone, or maybe an Orchid here in this game, who knows? I mean, up against Lashrak, an Orchid would be absolutely great. Being able to zip in on him and bring him down without him actually being able to do anything. But then again, Tusk may do that for you, so...
Yeah.
Plenty of fighting potential here once again for Burton United. And Abraxas, they have to find a way to play up against that.
Yeah, definitely. And they had some trouble last game. I still think they definitely have a shot in game number two here.
Yeah, they do. I mean, it's...
especially with Lashrak. I mean, everybody's favorite blue space goat.
Well,
or least favorite.
Oh, there's the Undying. Okay, Initiator will be happy about that.
I mean, so this hero is too good. You can't pass him up. You can, first of all, make the enemy team squishier. Second of all, you've got an amazing team fight ability in Tombstone. You've got great sustain with Soul Rip, and in case your team needs a little more damage, you have your ult, which makes everything take more damage from everything.
Yep. Well, you're a little bit of a Undying fanboy, I guess.
I mean, I've got like a 75% win rate with him because I lost the game last night, which was stupid. Actually, wait, that one didn't count, so 80%.
Okay.
Server issues.
Server issues, yeah.
DDoS.
Of course. But I would agree, Undying is a strong hero. The problem that I have with him is that if it does go late, he doesn't scale particularly well. I mean, Tombstone will at some point will just not do anything anymore. They won't be scared. I mean, it will get to a point where anyone inside of Burton United will just be able to right click it a couple of times and then it will be gone, right? DK as well doesn't really scale all too well. Soul Rip can be quite nice as a heal as well as a nuke. But then it comes really down to just, alright, I'm here, I amplify damage, look at me.
Yeah.
Dire team pick.
And,
there's
a point where if you've not played Undying correctly, you're headed into late game and you're not prepared to. And another hero who's very good against him is Nyx Assassin. Pick. I mean, you're looking at burning mana based on his intelligence. Undying is the smartest zombie to ever walk the earth. I mean, he gets crazy intelligence gains. So, hey, there we go. Undying, great target for mana burn.
Also, absolutely great pickup up against Lushrak. I mean, not just the mana burn, but also just due to the fact that Lushrak has so much AoE damage that he can't necessarily control where it goes. That spike carapace will stun him every single time. That's 2.4 seconds at level 4. And... Lushrak, if you manage to lock him down and then have heroes that can get on top of him, like a Storm Spirit, like a Tusk, then he's actually not all that OP because he will be dead in the fights and he can't actually throw out too much. Nagasaren, though, very smart pickup here from Abraxas. That's the one hero that can just say, nope, let me sing for a while and then we reevaluate if he still want to fight or not. And that can be crucial in just keeping the Lushrak alive or just stacking up zombies here. Nagasaren on Dying combo. Can be quite nasty in that regard as well.
Yeah, I'm a little torn on the Nagasaren pickup. The one thing I can say is that if you do Song and throw down Tombstone right on top of it, Even though the heroes are invulnerable, zombies will continue to spawn. So that gets you a free 2 zombies right off the bat there, already on each enemy, which is quite a big deal in my opinion. But Huskar coming forward, looks like it is a support Naga, which I like a lot better. I didn't think they had the potential to go late game with the Undying, as we talked about before. Huskar is much nicer here. They have a lot of magic damage that they want to deal with. Spike Carapace, though, still pure damage. Tusk, with that physical Walrus Punch, it is a little risky. But of course, they do have the Naga Siren to bail Huskar out of those really tough situations.
Yeah. Well, Spike Carapace, it's pure damage, but it's not really... not really a spell that you can finish off Huskar with, because it's
Have to be him life-breaking you.
Yeah.
And pretty much only that.
Yeah, it does reflect one damage instance. That's pure damage. So. Yeah. Huskar just right clicks him once and it's like, I'm stunned. Whatever. Huskar doesn't really give a damn. So.
Yeah.
This Husk can be much more of a problem here, just with the lockdown that he's able to provide later on. Just with the Walrus Punch.
I could see Burden United almost going for Anti-Mage here. The problem being Naga Siren, because you can net him and he's like, okay, I can't blink.
Yep.
Other than that, it looks like a great Anti-Mage game. He's good against Huskar. Not perfect, but good. He's good against Lashrak. He's just alright against Undying, but he will survive the lane at least, because he can burn his mana. I could see this happen. Now, Anish did mention in the Skype chat here that Big Gnome has played Tusk 3 of his past 10 games, and he's won all 3 times. One of the times was the previous matchup of these two teams. So, I'm sure they know this pick. They are scared of it.
Yeah, it kind of had to be scared of a Tusk. I mean, it's one of these heroes, especially recently. We've seen it in TI so much, pretty much every single game, on top there with the Gyrocopter in terms of popularity, just because he can bring you so much in the hands of a good player. But yeah, the last couple of picks here, Klings, that's a lot of physical damage here that they have been lacking up until now. And the Tempest Assassin up against that though, and correct me if I'm wrong, but there's not a whole lot of damage over time here on Burden United to deal with Refraction.
I mean, Klings has relatively quick attack speed.
But only with Strafe, right?
The one thing they do have is Storm Spirit. Storm Spirit, he doesn't do damage over time, but he does a lot of different instances of damage with Remnant, and then his right click, and then Ball Lightning, and then another right click. So that is probably their best offense against TA. However, she's still going to have a pretty exciting game here, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I'm going to predict a aggressive trailing for Abraxas. It's going to be TA mid. Leshrac's played by support. So offlane Undying.
Yeah, offlane Undying, and then
okay,
support Lesh.
Same.
Okay, that's something that we don't see often these days. Yeah. I mean, I think he was meant to be a support from the beginning.
Initially, yeah. But he definitely has a lot of potential as a core.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, with the constant buffs that Lightning Storm has gotten, plus the power creep from the Octarine core, I mean, it was just so valuable in a core position. But yeah. Luffy here not even having the Tormented Staff Immortal means that he can't play a core, so... He'll be a support Leshrac here on the side of Abraxas, joining him here on that support side. It's gonna be Zen'Gata on the Naga Siren. We've got Ascendancy playing that one position Huskar at the speed of light, or life. Speed of life, that's actually his proper name. He's playing the Templar Assassin mid. And Pwn on the Undying offlane.
Yep, and on the other side for Burden United, of course, we're going to have Come With Me, actually, on the Tusk, surprisingly enough. Yapstor will be on the Coddle this time. Autolus or Hook, going to be on your Storm Spirit. But Big Num on the Nyx Assassin in the offlane, so it is a support Tusk, it looks like. And Mind Control will be on the Klinks, looking to go aggressive here up against Huskar. And I can't blame him for that. He's got a lot of early physical damage. And Huskar, he does start out with a Ring of Protection, but he still only has 4 armor with that.
Those searing arrows will be a big, big problem for Huskar here throughout the entirety of the game. I mean, I think that's a good answer to this Huskar problem. But the thing is, with Huskar and TA here in the game as well, we talked about how Storm Spirit is actually a decent hero up against TA with the damage instances that he does. He actually does 2 with one right click once he gets the overload. It's just the magical part from the overload and the actual normal right-click, so you can't deal with refraction. It doesn't mean that Templar Assassin is necessarily going to lose the lane or not have a big impact here in the mid-game. And that's what I'm most worried about right now for Burden United, that they will at some point just have to deal with the Templar Assassin that's too strong.
Yeah.
But yeah, once again, guys, if you're just tuning in, welcome. This is the second game in the Special 3 series between Burden United and Abraxas. We are in the John Dota League playoffs. This is actually the final match of this playoffs. And yeah, the winner of this will be able to play in the Pro League Season 3.
Yeah. So, Ascendancy is actually a very prominent Klink's hero. But Klink's player, excuse me. So it'll be very interesting, as Anish has pointed out, to see how he deals with Klink's here. As he's clearly familiar with how much damage it's going to do. I mean, picking up that Ring of Protection shows it away instantly, but here comes the damage, and it
is
there's
a snowball here, and Ascendancy might be in first blood. One more right click should do it, and there it is. The net on to come with me might be the counter kill with the tower helping out. No, maybe not. Maybe Zenigata will be giving up the second kill. Nah, six base armor. That's enough to deal with the right clicks here.
Klink's running out of mana pretty quickly. They're gonna look to make a movement in here. Now, keep in mind, net will reveal Indus, so...
Oh, top lane! Oh, Luffy actually took so much damage from that Illuminate Pwn. Still fighting up against them with the DK. There's some interesting lanes here as well. I mean, offlane Undying, but dual lanes always a potential with that hero, especially if you have someone like Lushrak. If he gets off a stun, If they get a couple of elves as well, if they get a stun, oh, speaking of stuns, Luffy is the one caught with them, but now Tombstone goes down, no Illuminate just yet, and now Bignum. Might be in a little bit of trouble here. Oh, maybe not, Tombstone actually goes down pretty damn quickly. Now the Mango comes out, another stun is available. Pwn might be in trouble if he can land the stun. He definitely can now, he is, he's sitting in a tree, he's one more wreck, will do it. That's the second blood. He in the top lane this time, but once again, going the way of Burn United.
Yeah, and that's just level 1 Tombstone. I mean, it only has 175 HP. It's basically two
Zenigata
or three
as well.
Oh.
And he's denied himself to creeps. Come with me was chasing him, and you would have caught him with that boots advantage. Man,
yeah,
okay.
Use him to use tricks against him.
Very strong start here once again from Burden United, and yeah, I was mentioning how I'm afraid that the Templar Assassin can just take over the game, but of course if... Well, same can be said for Storm Spirit. He can have a similar impact. Just all depends on how much space everyone else is creating for them. Looks like Burn United is in a good spot to do just that.
Yeah, we'll see at the speed of doing fine in the mid lane here. But Storm Spirit is edging ahead. I mean, that's what I talked about in the draft. Storm is very good against TA, especially in the laning stage. Now, later on, TA can become quite the menace.
Bottom lane. They're gonna go and come with me here, and some good damage here with Luffy rotating in. There's net to secure the kill. Bignum comes in, but it doesn't actually have enough. Oh, there's a snowball actually saving him for now, but one more right click will do it.
If he'd stayed in that snowball a little longer, I think he actually might have lived. Because the Huskar spears don't do damage to you while you're off the map, obviously, and they were expiring, but he did throw it off a little early, I think. Because what's the charge?
I don't know. There were three heroes still around him. So, and he was so low on health that one right kick from either of them would have finished him off, so I'm not so sure. Unless Bignum would have gotten the perfect 3-man impale, but...
Meanwhile, up at the top rune, Autolu's looking for the rune, he will actually grab it, and at the speed of, in a bit of trouble, 127 HP does have 8 stick charges, which is going to be very helpful against Storm.
He will survive there. Huh. I just keep watching all the lanes, because the way these two teams have been playing, it's always the potential of fights breaking out at every single point on the map. Now
especially
Luffy even...
First damage on most of these heroes.
Oh no! No! Did you see that?
I missed it, no.
No, Autolus had the bottle here, sitting on the ground for the courier to pick up, and at the speed of light just came in and picked it off.
No, wait a second.
Stormsford just lost his bottle.
Completely?
Completely. He got
no
it got
way.
Auto-attacked. Oh man, I can't even be...
courier, and I was like, wait, there's a bottle on the courier. Why does it belong to... Huh? But that's terrible.
Yeah, that's okay. Templar Assassin's bottle, but Stormsbird...
Oh,
that's...
and Ascendancy going down on the bot lane.
Keep missing kills, but I'm just so flustered by that. That is such an uncharacteristic mistake for a player like this.
Okay, he has rebought a bottle, but I mean, that's 700 gold gone.
Yeah.
I mean, CS for him means nothing now, because he's not actually ahead.
Oh, man.
Nyx is going to get his bottle as well here, but Storm needs his right now. I mean, he needs it against TA. You just take so much damage against her that you have to make something happen there.
And with that, yeah, that's kind of lane one for TA, I would say. Bottle, it's just such a big pickup ever since they started upping the price of the bottle as well. I think it used to be 650
or 600. That's almost to the point of losing your tranquil boots or something.
Yeah. Hidden ones,
green. Almost. Invisibility. It used to be 600. The impurities. Then it was 650. And then it was 700, I think.
Bottom lane here, big num stalking Luffy. And we'll find, oh, so much damage done. And the creeps, no, they attack big num. They're not cooperating with Luffy in this instance, so it's not gonna be the die. But a nice little pickoff here, making use of that level 6 on the next assassin, so crucial as well. Similar to how Clockwork needs to make something happen once he hits level 6, next assassin is in the same boat. That'll bring him closer to his arcane boots, but meanwhile mid, Temple Assassin might be in a little bit of trouble here, out of three faction charges now, we'll have another set, 2 seconds on, there's the teleport reactions here. Nice net here, on to come with me, follow-up stun from Luffy, there's the follow-up damage here from everything else recently, Lightning Storm, yeah, it's still going on Orlus, force the zip away, that'll force him off the lane as the bottle is just now, making his way back, and yeah, nice reactions here, and of course Temple Assassin, with refraction, really hard to bring down without proper damage over time.
Yeah, Sigil was trying to do some work there, but it just wasn't enough just at level 1. And the snowball cooldown was just a bit too high as well, so... That's why you see players often level the snowball over the Sigil, just to have that reduced cooldown and the extra damage you get.
But yeah, come with me. Just playing like last game a little bit, already at 2 kills. Yeah, it worked out for them in the last game, so you can't really fault them too much for that. The problem is, though, now this Temple Assassin now sitting on top of this CS chart, we can take a quick look at the net worth, and yeah, also that department. And that's the kind of territory where you have to be very, very careful about how far you let this go. Because Temple Assassin with a quick early deso. It's just so much burst damage. Yeah, it becomes a monster. It's so much burst damage from a single melt strike, and it's akin to a Vendetta strike from Bignum on a much, much lower cooldown.
I mean, you've got 6 seconds there. That is easy. They are going to throw down a tombstone.
Oh, yeah, sir.
Trying to chase down Coddle, but the slow coming out, keeping him from going down just yet. He doesn't have a zombie on him, at least. And now, Clink's going to come around and try to get it on the action. Tombstone's still up here. He doesn't really want to approach it.
He just strafes and takes it out, yeah. tries to
deny
it.
I'm trying to deny it. It is 150 gold, so...
That's quite a decent chunk of money there, especially for Klinks, who has some lifting to do in this game, we would say. Actually rotated him up to the safe lane here a while back, so he can get a safe farm and utilize the jungle a little bit more safely as well.
Meanwhile, Ascendancy getting picked off. TA making the trade for Come With Me, though. And Big Num in a bit of trouble. He should be able to get away if he... Yeah, he pops the magic wand. He has a stun if he needs it. Gonna try to take down Luffy with him, and he's probably gonna get even if it's lost his life. He's got another Spike Carapace.
Still surviving now. That's the Spike Carapace. Only lasting for a couple of seconds. And actually, there's another slow. Okay. He should fall now.
Yeah, he's dead. Okay, with the refraction, but it gives Come With Me enough time to get back in here. Not sure he really wants to be there. That actually takes down the dominating streak there for the TA, which gets her quite a bit of gold. It's going to be a Ring of Aquila up for her.
Yeah, so a little bit of a better trade than Burden United would have gotten otherwise. Just getting Luffy there, but still giving up a streak to a Temple Assassin. As I said time and time again, it's a dangerous proposition if you give that hero farm early.
Yeah, Yapzor has been stacking up camps, though, to not only help out Storm Spirit, but get himself his Tranquil Boots. And Storm will be working on Soul Ring pretty quickly here, it looks like.
Keep missing these kills.
Every time there's a kill, there's like two more on the map at the same time.
Yeah. It's always the case when I'm casting with you. It seems like, and I'll lose. Actually, he's so slow. The traps are prepared for four, and now he doesn't have any mana anymore. Does get some with Yapsa coming in, but yeah, it's not enough, or is it? Slow comes out again, dodges that right click, but not the next one. Oh man.
And this is what I was talking about. CA just becoming a monster. She's already got 1100 gold and just picked up that Ring of Aquila.
Yeah.
We're looking at a pretty fast SO. I'd say 14 minutes ish if she keeps this up.
Some really good trap placement as well. There's two here, I think, and one more up top. Sloan Storms were down so much that even with the zip, it's only so much you can jump with the mana that you have, even with the Caudle. Just trying to help you out with that Chakra. Yeah, that's another big kill.
At the speed of life,
according to Dendora. Aura.
Yeah, but at the speed of traps, maybe? No? Okay.
And they slow you down, right? So.
Yeah, exactly, but it's still speed Dyer's of some sort. It's just low speed.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Pwn might be in trouble here in the top. Big Num. Just get the angle for a stun. Yeah, there's a snowball. Tombstone is down, though. Is that going to be enough for the top reactor coming in to actually save him? Save him, no, but maybe they can get some. No, it's actually not coming. Cancel the teleports, so. Get everything I just said.
You've got to be able to throw down a decay as well. If you just throw down the tombstone, they're like, okay, we're going to stun lock you and keep you down. If he'd thrown a decay right before that, he could possibly have gotten them down to that death lust, which would have added on more slow to the attacks of the zombies. They do slow a little bit anyway. Or they did at one point. I guess they don't anymore. But the death lust is what really slows it. You got to be at 400 HP or 35% to get that going.
Bottom lane here, mind control. Looking for Luffy. 1, 2, 3, 4. The stun comes off, but that's about everything. Yeah. Nice and easy pick up here for Kling. It's just the type of stuff that he can do. So he's sitting up top there in his own team in terms of net worth, but oh, top lane, there's a snowball here onto Pwn once again. Gets bursted down, maybe here, yeah, with the Illuminate here, that's going to be enough. Now Zangata doesn't have a song yet, they want their hero as well. They're trying to juke around the tower, but Big Num here. Oh, can he get the right one? Yes, he can.
Nicely played there by Nyx. Yeah, unfortunately, looks like Zangata was having a bit of a sore throat today. Won't be able to sing just yet.
Yeah, still level 5 and... Yeah, both of these heroes, in fact. Actually, no, Undying's level 9, but he's not opted to get the ultimate just yet. Yeah. What's your take on that? Do you pick up the ultimate level 6 on Undying, or do you just...
I usually do, but I actually can see why you don't. I mean...
Oh, hang on. Bottom lane, they see Mind Control here, trying to teleport out, but there's the net, there's the stun. Big pickoff here, that's a dominating spree for at the speed of life.
Yep, and he's looking very good, but the Undying, since they nerfed it to be like a minimum damage amp of 1% instead of 5%, it can be pretty lackluster, especially if the heroes are staying out of your reach. Now, if you're right up against them, and especially against the Tusk, this is why I'm really surprised he didn't pick it up, the level 1 ult is great, because they're right up against you, they feel the full effects of it. But once they get away, it's pretty lackluster.
Looks like the pace of the game slowed down a little bit here, and not quite sure if that favors Burden United, to be honest, because the Templar Assassin's still farming here, looking for the Desolator, as I said, and with that item being so cheap now, he almost has it.
Yeah, and so, they're gonna have a stack coming up for him in just a second.
Yeah. So maybe Initiator, gold. you can just look up some Desolated Timing for Templar Assassin, because I have a feeling this is going to be a good one.
Radiance middle okay, yeah, he's not going to go attack. For it. Now, Klinks has opted for the Medallion here. What do you think about that?
I really like that, to be honest. It's just gives him so much extra damage and so much extra pickup potential. It's kind of a poor man's Desolator, in a sense.
Yep. I mean, it does the same amount of armor reduction.
Yeah, it does. But thing is, Klinks, he wants to just go in, put on a strafe, right-click a couple times, and then get out again. And that's exactly what the Medallion gives you. You get the extra damage from his Searing Arrows anyway, so don't necessarily need that from the Desolator. So, really nice cost-effective item for him, I think. Yeah, they're gonna get Roshan now with that as well. It's another thing that it does for you. And yeah, Braxis, either they don't know, they don't feel like they can fight that. With the Tombstone, though, we can always fight the Rosh. Just putting that on the high ground, but... Yeah,
it was interesting that they didn't put a trap in the pit. He put one on the high ground over here, and then one at the rune, and said, okay, we've got it covered. But apparently wasn't enough.
And I have to put one in the pit, just make sure that there are any smoke shenanigans. I mean, I think mind control invist in there.
It is only level 1, so he may not have wanted to sacrifice another trap to do
maybe.
As well.
Well, mid tier 1 will go down.
Dire's top tower is under pretty easy. I mean, Clinks is a tower pushing man. Has fallen.
Niigata though, misses the ice charge, still has the song, might have to use it here. As gets hit by the sun from Big Nom. Can he get it off? That's the next question. No! That is the answer here, but now. Tombstone already down. And there's the
dust.
Yeah, there's the dust to reveal something. I don't know. Come with me, we'll get chased down here. By TA and Undying. No one else though, so it's a 1-for-1 trade for now. Big Nom slowed down a little bit. Asuka does not opt to go for it, but there's a slow here. The trap comes out. I think Ascendancy could have gotten that, I think.
I was looking at the circle. He was just out of range. It was pretty unfortunate, but...
there's also another problem here with 4 points dominance by Carapace. If you leap into the tower like that, you're going to get stunned for a long time. So.
And you're taking tower hits then, too, which hurt Huskar a lot. I mean, he's got 11 armor now, but it's still not a lot. You want to have a lot more TA coming on in.
They want to fight this. There's another tombstone in 5 seconds, and Burn United. I think Battlehood, they just try to illuminate, spam it out. But Braxis take another tier 1 tower. Alright, so item build for Huska, actually. He does have the Helm of the Nominate, it looks like, after the Omelette.
Probably, yeah.
Oh, yeah,
I mean,
even.
The veil, but it's probably Helm of the Nominator.
And at the speed of life here, with the really good desolated timing here, about 30-40 seconds here before the average even. Now a big ancient stack as well. To
Tusk,
actually bring it. Oh god,
target,
Tusk. Maybe not here. There's a net. Not the follow-up stun here from Big Nom. Not actually seeing him there. It looks like here, even though that's a dire sentry ward.
Yeah, he didn't have the high ground vision, and Nyx just coming in invis, storm through it, staying on the high ground. They baited that out very nicely because. With, I think it was Leshrac or Undying there, they thought they could turn the fight, but it wasn't going to be enough. TA now with a blink, and this is where it gets really scary. I mean, the fact that she could already come close to one-shotting Storm means, even if he thinks he can zip away, blink meld hit doesn't take long at all.
Absolutely. But I almost feel like Zenigata has to be more liberal with the song usage. I mean, sure, it's still level 1, very long cooldown, but... Well, if you don't use it at all, you're not going to get anything out of it. I mean, maybe he wants to just keep it for defensive purposes, but with TA in a position where it is, you don't actually need to do that. So, maybe if you saw Big Nom there, then you would have popped it and made sure that TA had enough time to come in.
The problem is against Storm, though. If you song aggressively against Storm, he just zips out. Unless you get a perfectly timed Leshrac stun, but maybe they just aren't as confident in their ability to do that. We will see a mana leaf come out on Poe.
Yeah, he does get locked down. Mass teleports, but not before the pickoff will actually happen. Link is still available for at speed of life, but not up to go for that just yet.
They will take down the sigil, which gets rid of the vision. Are they going to continue here?
Oh, there's
the
blink. Big Nom. Still has the spike carapace, and also nice pushback here. From keep up life.
Nice shards.
And good zoning here once again from BU. Yeah, at
they
this point they can't chase
it, but they were on the wrong side of it, so that was very well played by Tusk. Wow, so we just gained about 120 gold per minute with that, which that's a lot of gold. It was a triple stack, you said, right?
I think a triple stack,
okay.
3 or 4.
Yeah, that's a lot of gold right there, especially this early in the game. And that's one of the other big benefits of TA, being able to use Psyblades and your Deso to take that big ancient stack early in the game.
Oh, Storm's weird.
That other heroes might not be able to do. Nice escape from Storm.
Had enough mana there. Oh, the shots don't actually block out at the speed of life. And Arlous, even though he does have that Aegis, he does not actually have enough mana. Actually zip much further, but with the sigil coming out, slowing at the speed of life down.
Yeah. They wanted to go up cliff with that trap, but better just to hold on to it for later.
Oh, Big Nom here. The cover of Zim is here looking for Luffy. I'm not quite sure if he knows the Temple Assassin there to counterattack.
He's too far away now, though.
Yeah. They need more detection here. Luffy just being bursted down.
And he grabs Undying as well.
Yeah.
He's got a four staff.
Four staff after the nets. Yeah, he should be alright, unless the Temple Assassin can wrap around entirely. He still has the blink, of course, to help him do that. Oh, they really want this pesky Nyx Assassin here. There's a trap, there's a tombstone as well. Spike Carapace made it out now. And now there it is. Melt Strike. Boom! One shot from 2/3 health.
And even if he did get the invis, yeah. Naga has some sentries, so.
Yeah. He also another kill streak as well, so.
Yeah.
The Pinata strat is actually working out well for Braxis here. It's Radiant's almost 12,000 net worth on this Templar Assassin.
I mean, Big Gnome is finding some kills, but is it enough? Storm Spirit gonna go in on Huskar, he'll lock him down. Yapster are gonna try to get an Illuminate off in time. It'll do some damage, but it's not enough. With Huskar's high magic resist, it'll be just fine. Tusk, not actually gonna go in. Sorry, I thought that was a snowball. But meanwhile, up top, TA and Undying are pushing the tower.
Space created for both teams here. Oh, bottom lane, Luffy will get bursted down here. Ascendancy now finally looking to maybe make something happen, but no, mana drained, and actually, nice. Very nice blinding light there, but it's going to be enough ascendancy here. He's turning on man mode here. Will fall, but not before bringing down the clings low enough for TA to pick up. Yep, so we'll teleport in plain sight. That'll be that. So yeah, a lot of space being created here. T2 top did fall, but so did the T2 bottom when they were doing the big chase on the next assassin. Braxis, I feel like they're being kited around a little bit all across the map. I mean, sure, you have the Temple Assassin with that high net worth, but yeah, he can only be at one place at a time, can he?
Yeah. And another thing is, the Cottle up against Huskar matchup. Usually you'd say, okay, well, Huskar destroys Cottle. Yes, to an extent, but Mana Leak is very good against him. Huskar, he only has one spell that uses mana. He does not need much mana. So he doesn't have a big mana pool. And therefore, one Mana Leak, level one, does a lot against him. And just giving you that extra stun against Huskar, especially when he wants to be very mobile around the map.
Yep. It's definitely worked out very well in the last game. He was already low mana to begin with, then the Mana Leak, plus a blinding light as well. Just being able to push him around like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's absolutely valuable, but yeah. Keep off the light. He does have the Aghanim Scepter as well, so he's actually pretty damn farmed. Support. So once it's daylight, you do have that extra heal from the Illuminate, you do have that unobstructed vision. So now Abraxas might be looking for fights at nighttime. Did they see Orlus here? No, they might have seen it pick up the the Invis? Maybe.
Maybe. I'm not
they
really
definitely
sure.
See him now, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, Abraxas, they're looking all across the map, but they're just not finding anything. Meanwhile, bottom lane here, mind control and come with me, they're still pushing out.
And with that Deso on Clanks as well, is a lot of damage coming out from him. I mean, ever since that started stacking with Searing Arrows, I still prefer the Helm of the Dominator just to get the extra damage from your creeps and health as well. But Deso is a very powerful item on him.
Yep. A Deso plus Medallion of Coverage, so it's kind of like two Desos for a single target. Pretty strong, but it's also a very late Midas here coming out from Nyx Assassin, so I don't know. I know one guy, shout out to that Phage guy, who would be shouting and screaming right now, why the Midas? That's a good question, actually. Why the Midas? Did you feel like this will go late game?
I don't feel like it. I feel like either team wants it to go early game. That being said, though, since neither team
Big Gnome
really
finds Luffy again. It's not quite burst him down. Pwn with a mechanism will be able to keep him alive. And now, Spike Carapace forced out early with the tombstone as well. Can they really chase him down? Maybe they can, but not with Autolus coming in here, looking to finish what they started. But there's also a Glimmer Cape. Once again, Luffy being kept alive by Steamer tries to get a stun, but Autolus will dodge it. Now, Pwn out of mana, pops the stick charges, and now no more health coming from either side. So it's a 2v2 here, and as I guess Sensei slowly but surely making his way over here. That was a scrappy fight here. Pwn just being able to keep Luffy alive through all of that with the mech and the Glimmer Cape. Now, yeah, the turnaround. Sensei looking for something. And Storm Zips too early. Didn't actually get the.
He's got more than
get the jump off in time though.
Yeah, he's okay.
I think if you start to jump and then Storm zips away, you still follow him, right?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah. Keep in mind though, there is that Ags up on Cottle, so Storm is gonna have a really easy time right now. He can just TP back to base, you can bring him in, etc.
Yeah.
So.
At the same time, that bottom tier 3 on the Radiant side took quite a bit of damage doing all of that with just Klings and Come With Me on the Tusk just pushing out. And looks like Braxis don't really have a solution for that just yet. Don't have a solution for the split push. What can they do though? I mean, Vision is one thing. I mean, that's speed of light. Speed of life here, followed by Mind Control, and now he is all alone. Oh no, that's easy burst. He's alive.
What he was looking for.
Not really.
I mean, they've got a trap in the pit now, but with the damage on Klinks at the moment, I don't think they really should contest this. It looks like they don't care.
Can't really contest this though without the Temple Assassin. That's the main damage here. They still do though. That's a Tombstone on top. That's the Song of the Siren. Everyone lined up nicely with little to no mana even. Some zombies will start to stack up. There's the follow-up stun a little bit mistimed. Arlus will be able to zip around, bring down Luffy here. The rest of Burn United very low on health and mana with an army of zombies behind them. That's Come With Me going down. Arlus here also caught by the net. He has to zip out now. He's out of mana. Mind Control though, barely able to survive at 30 life points. Ignom, they see him, they have a sentry for him at the very least. Do you have any more though? Yes, there is, but... Can they actually bring him down? Ah, one more DK, not enough. With the Stick Charge as well on Nyx Assassin, so... Oh, now Odalus coming back in here. Zendikata will fall. Ascendancy re-entering the fight here. Looking to chase the Storm Spirit out once more. That's such a scrappy fight. TA still not alive again. Now Ascendancy, yeah, control down. Can he toggle this? Yeah, he can start toggling here, but he will still fall to Autolus, not pwn, out of mana, out of anything. He will fall again, so it's a team wipe across a couple of minutes. Now we are back where we started. Burning Knight have taken this Roshan. So, actually nothing gained from Braxis, just because they took a fight without their highest farmed hero. I really can't really understand that. I mean, sure, you have the Tombstone, but if you... That was a perfect lineup here. That would have been a perfect Psyblades right there at the edge of the pit, but they didn't have that.
Yeah, and they weren't going to be able to song long enough for TA to respawn.
No.
That wasn't even close to a possibility. She will have an MKB, though, so that's going to help you out a lot. Did she have this a few minutes ago? I may be mistaken here.
Probably. At one point, he was banking a lot of gold and probably just one-shot bought that.
I mean, he's sitting at 580 gold per minute, so...
Yeah.
Nyx might... He
will
scout
him out, but he can't really kill a solo kill type assassin. Oh, maybe he can with Autolus joining as well. Silence from some freshly purchased orchid. No, not so freshly purchased orchid, but...
That Soulburn really was taking him down. And this is really good on this team. It means Klinks doesn't have to go for it. He can go for bigger and better items. Thank you, Anish.
Yep.
And also, their high burst damage anyway. It helps them bring down heroes a lot easier. And it's very good against every hero on the side of ABX.
Okay, but yeah, that sounds good. We haven't actually talked about Hooker in a while, ever since he lost the bottle in a tragic fashion, but he's been able to catch up very nicely. He's sitting now above the Temple Assassin in terms of net worth, thanks to these last couple of pickoffs. And Orchid, Bloodstone, Aegis? Now he's the guy that you have to watch out for, because that's exactly where Stormsword wants to be.
Yep, and although there is a Glimmer Cape bump in the Undying, he's using it more for initiation purposes than defensively, and...
Oh, there's Snowball here in the back. They do get the Naga Siren turnaround, maybe from Ascendancy, but it doesn't see it come with me. Where's Shadow Blade? The Invis in this team.
How did he get a Shadow Blade? When?
I don't know. There's some zip here, although on the pwn they find him, even though. Alright, he's trying to teleport out and recover the Glimmer Cape. We'll be able to do so. But still, the tower goes down. Another hero falls down in the bottom lane. Burn United, once again, they're asserting so much pressure all across the map, and in Braxis, they don't feel like they have a solution.
Yeah.
Their solution so far has been to send TA out on solo mission somewhere for no reason whatsoever. And now, once again, they find themselves in their own base, desperately trying to defend all three lanes that are pushed across the river.
And this is a critical game for them, keep in mind. I mean, we talked about it at the very beginning of the draft. They lose this game, they're back in Division 2.
Yep. It's closest they're getting here to a shot of playing in the Pro League. It's looking more and more like Burn United will repeat their performance in the first round of the upper bracket, where they knocked down Abraxas 2-0. Yeah.
So they've got map vision like crazy. Map vision for weeks.
Yeah. I mean, it's nighttime right now, but once it turns daylight, you will we'll see the whole extent of that with that unlimited or unobstructed vision from the Aghanim Scepter plus the gem.
Yeah, I don't think he's had the gem when it was daytime, but... Well, he, never mind, he has for sure, because he's got 2k gold in the bank.
Yeah. Cypher Weiss now done in Klings as well. Game's just getting harder and harder, man.
That's
the one thing that Klings is lacking, which is, yeah. One thing that Klings is lacking, solid lockdown, you know? If Huskar can't toggle his armlet, what can he really do?
If he can't toggle his armlet, and also if he can't just man fight you, he can't get a ball. Before anything could even happen there.
Oh, Pwn, whiz! Teleport on the wrong side here, Song will keep him safe for now, but... Can he really turn this around once again without a TA? I feel like the buyback has to come out. There it is.
Yep.
Teleport comes in. Now there's a chance. They do get the leap onto mind control. Dust comes out, so he should fall. That's a big kill for them. Now they continue to chase here with Slow and Victim as well as Yapzur.
They get first here.
Yeah, they do see him. There's not a nice stun on four heroes though. They should still be able to follow him up with a blink dagger here. One right kick.
Halberd.
He has a halberd. Now it's pink. No, okay.
Oh,
surely that wasn't going to happen, but yeah. Keep off the light, trying to teleport out. Yeah, the net will follow him to the base.
Right?
I think it destroyed it.
I guess so. Okay. I could have sworn it couldn't be destroyed.
Now turn around here. Arlo's coming back in. He will give us life, but that's only the Aegis. Two heroes here. Now he'll just about. Oh, can he? Yes, he can. There's no lockdown between these heroes, not really. Of course, the net's great and all, but that will don't stop you from zipping around.
Through a meld strike. He almost
oh,
fell.
Wow.
That's
I'm minus 20 sure armor.
Yeah.
Both minus 20.
Is it minus 20? Good lord.
Yeah, I mean, meld strike plus this later. Meld gives minus 8 plus minus 7. Getting close.
15. Close enough, yeah.
It's at minus 20 on Storm for a second. Do they have any other minus armor? Oh yeah, of course the Riptide too.
Oh yeah.
That's another plus 5, okay, then it makes sense.
Yeah, and that actually is a great combo with the TA. Just having the Naga there to Riptide.
Yep. Sure if it's enough to actually get them back into this game though. Because right now as it stands, they have a Burn United, have a Storm Spirit and a Klings. Both of those heroes can just get on a target and burst them down immediately. Same for Nyx Assassin, really. He has been able to do that a couple of
and
times.
We're seeing
yes.
That on the right now.
Exactly like that, and yeah. Defend. aggressive GG here, okay.
Like, excuse me?
What? Misclick, okay. Oh, of course.
Misclick.
Misclick OBM, the big question. There's another zip here. Ascendancy, not long for the worlds. Actually, he's still alive for now. Now, can you turn around? There's a leap here about the Lincolns from Orlus. He since picked that up. We'll be able to keep him alive. He should have enough mana to zip out. Signum, though, maybe not as lucky. He's, he actually doesn't zip out at all. He just wants to fight here. Clay's coming from back here. Sanity is still alive, but hexed up now. Mind Control actually also disarmed here, but. It,
oh my goodness.
This is just so sad for Abraxas here. Burn United just too far out of this game.
If they hadn't picked off TA, she would have been in this fight.
Yeah.
She would have added a lot of damage to the fight and made them a lot more scared to engage. And at this point, they're not. Tusk picks up a Deso that they don't even need, keep in mind. Also slip here, come back. Easy, easy base dives, boys.
Yeah. That should be that. That should be that. They even dropped the Cypher Vice. And Stormsmith takes it for no reason whatsoever. I don't even know what they're doing anymore. But yeah, GG has to come out. There's no way for them to fight up, and yeah, just goes to show once again you can have all the network in the world. You just get picked off it before the fights.
It
doesn't do anything for you. Oh, that's.
He does say it was a misclick, so.
Yeah.
We'll have to take that at face value. Anyways.
Give them the benefit of the doubt there for sure, but yeah. Yeah, Rupture. Revo. I almost called you Rupture there. before we read off, your take on this game or on the series?
Burn United looking good. I was worried when they were disbanding, when Singen left the team and everything, that everything was going to fall apart. But they seem to have managed to pull some people together, and they're starting to look great. Autoluz and Yaps are great additions to the team right now. Hopefully they'll take up the tag soon.
Well, that's stands to be seen, of course. Burn United have been playing with a number of standings here the past couple of days. But yeah, definitely looking forward to seeing what they can bring in the Pro League, as that's what they had it here with 2-0 victory up against Abraxas. And yeah, that concludes the playoffs, actually. It's kind of sad, as I had a lot of fun here casting a lot of these matches here for Giant Dota.
But JDL Season 7?
Yeah, JDL Summer. Season 7 coming up, so watch out for that. There's plenty more great games coming up. All the info on that, of course, on joindota.com, so head on over there. While you're already browsing the interwebs, head on over to twitter.com, give me a follow at dragon.dota, and of course also my cohorts for this cast, SB Revolution 5, that's my co-caster, and of course, let's not forget our statsman here, Initiator, spelt with a 0 and an E as well at the front.
So,
well, maybe you can, if you're still in the game, you can pop that up in the stats box.
IAT0R.
But yeah, thank you very much for joining me, guys, and thank you guys very much for watching, and hope we'll see you next time.